Hey guys, how's it going? December 27th, 2021. Back in on Railroads Online. Yeah, we're just at the depot there. Bob was going somewhere. I got,
Think he's over at the smelter?
Yeah, he might be. Whoops, wrong one. Probably. Okay. Hey Bob, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Howdy.
Hey, hello. Okay, let me get back down to the depot.
Into the snow, did you?
Yeah, I saw where you were headed, so I thought, yeah, I'll take off down there. You have to open up another one, Emmett.
Yeah.
All right. Head back down south. Do do. Ironworks.
Well, no issues unloading the first load of cordwood.
Good.
Except I brought what I thought was 40 with me, 8 times 5. But when I put it in, it only registered 32, unless it used 8 right away. But it seemed odd that it would use the exact one car load.
Hmm.
But I haven't looked at the sheets to see what might have been in the coal. There's still one coal left, but there was obviously some things at 100 on the other side.
There's only 92. No, that's it. There you go. 92 raw, 92 raw iron, 79 rails out. It processed it.
Okay. Good.
And there should be one coal because there was nine, or iron ore.
Yep, there's one iron ore left.
So that's good.
Cool.
I'm just running back to the cell, so whenever you need to save.
Wow, the yard actually looks a bit bare now.
Bare? I thought you were going to say organized.
Oh, yay, we have Caduceus on map now, that's good.
the diamond. Oops, I was headed the right way though. As soon as I saw the curve there, I was like, oh, that's the wrong way. Time to rock and roll. Hey, Scott.
Hello, YouTube.
Right.
Wow, 30 cars going to the iron workers. That's fun.
Well, the beams could go to the coal mine too. They don't have to go to the iron mine. But two sets of beams and one set of lumber would be the perfect combination up at the iron ore mine.
Slack. That'd be fun. Did I get it this time? Damn.
It'll be fine. It doesn't matter. You're going to get the
middle. I unloaded that cordwood, Sean, so you can throw a save down anytime.
Roger that. You sure I'm okay spotted there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Using Emmett's bypass track for lumber logging camp to the smelter 3 times now today.
Yep.
Cool, going around all the switches.
Yeah, it's nice because usually they're not even set in the right direction.
Check to see something. Yeah, it's right at the freezing mark right now. It's supposed to get warmer overnight. Or I'm looking at the wrong one. Yeah, are they? Yep. Till it's freezing by the morning. It's not too bad tomorrow. So much for that really nice day. So I know where the tools and the pipe are here. I forget what order they are over there. It'll determine whether or not I go forward or backwards. Do you remember of it? I can't remember either. So one thing you'll have to be careful with, was it the leftmost button you're using?
I am, yeah.
Okay. I was just thinking of this. For me, it's not going to hurt. But when you go to grab the door, you could be unloading a boxcar. I'm not saying you would.
Well, I'll have to remember that when I get to that part of the game, if I do it, to see if it's a conflict or not.
If not, you can try a right mouse button.
I think you can drag the door open.
Yeah, but it wasn't working half the time.
That's right.
I think if you drag the door open, you'll be fine though, because I don't think I think it will only work unless it has a click on drag or hold.
Well, it's a lot of tools to go dumping.
Yeah, no.
You could try it with one tool, say, for an example.
Another option is to just always keep the door open.
85 Fahrenheit. Jeez. Well, zero here is 32, so it's... But 85 is nice.
That was the one. Sean filled it up with firewood, but he forgot to put water in it. She's thirsty. Good thing you noticed that before you headed out.
I always check every time I hop on the server. That's the one thing people don't think about because they don't have to look at it, especially if they do it in first person all the time. They never check until, well, they're out of steam.
All right.
They fixed the graphics bug with the groundwork.
It's better.
It's a pretty common thing for two textures to be occupying the same place to flicker back and forth.
Yep.
I do remember reading that they tried to fix it, and some people had limited success saying it was fixed.
It's better.
It's better. It happens less often.
I think it only works when you're placing groundwork. Existing groundwork isn't affected by it.
Gosh, shoot.
When I was redoing groundwork in my world, I didn't have that graphics problem, but still existing groundwork that I hadn't touched.
Right, if
I'd have to
literally
redo the entire map,
more or less. Yeah, I don't think you want
to
do that.
Yeah. Ooh. Aw, crap.
I like how with Mogul Dash. They actually did make the pipe it sound realistic to the real thing.
Well, that's cool.
Now they just need the really low-pitched bubble of the whistle. Oh, that was a shivers down my spine here.
Thank you. So what are you doing today? Tomorrow, isn't it?
I'm not sure, really. Probably somewhat similar to today.
Yeah.
Just load it up on train, Sean. Can you throw a save down at any time?
Sure. Done.
Did you see my picture, Zan, of the crashing Betsy? So now if you're using the UI for a locomotive and you just jump out of it, the throttle stays the same, the brake stays the same.
Say
is they stay the same, and today I crashed, and when I logged back in, my train was not where I crashed, so I had to run up the line towards the logging camp to find it, and I did, and it was at the end of the line, and they were all the cars are on top of each other because I just kept driving.
Even before that, oftentimes when you crash, they do that. Not as much, but still would.
It takes a lot to load these things up.
Yeah.
I have my regulator at 0, but he's shown that's at 17%. Why do they really have to fix things that isn't really broken?
Well, because maybe they're not broken for you, but they're broken for someone else. As the squeaky wheel gets the oil, and if 5 people complain about something, they're liable to change it, never, you know, not caring that the other 95% of the people like the way it is.
I wish they'd think we could actually toggle it if one of those things you're not going to like. Well, it's farming some R22 where you can toggle on weeds and all that stuff if you really want or feel like it.
Yeah, that would be cool.
The problem with toggleability is it can present bugs, and I think they're probably going to work on the individuality first and then eventually give it the ability to have that. Just so you can single out the bugs.
Yeah, we have no idea what options they're going to give us at the end game. They still have to add all kinds of admin options, kicking people, moderating people,
banning people permanently.
Yeah. Having an in-game chat so you can talk to each other.
But it wasn't a running locomotive. That
would be fun. Plus, they keep having an endless supply of bugs.
Move 20 bugs, get 50 more. It's just... it sucks.
Hey, Mark. Stop yawning. I think I had 7 some odd hours sleep. pipe this time. Funny feeling I was going to do that eventually.
I was expecting the other one to go first, but...
Yeah, whatever. Shift it around. I have to shift it forward anyways. What? Did you see that?
Yeah, well,
oh, okay. Okay, never mind.
Pulling up to the water tank with 13 gallons of water left, or 13 liters.
Units, whatever.
We've had to need
12.
Need a rescue.
11. Oh no, there's a locomotive in the way for me to get water.
Where are you at? The depot?
I was filling up Dixie.
tried several times and I'm just dead.
Couldn't find the brake. Need a rescue?
No, we're good. I'm at the...
Right.
Just in front of the water tank, there's a locomotive here that Zane was going to use. The spout was down in the water tank. It's at 229 of 360.
Wow.
And my internet completely puked on me. I can't even get on Microsoft Edge.
You'll have to wait till they all go to bed or get up early in the morning before they wake up.
Yeah, me too.
You gotta get your game time in with your new PC.
I should do it right.
What do you think of these new engine houses we got, Sam?
I screwed something up there. I don't know what I was thinking. No, I wanted to go forward. I wanted to finish off that. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah. Sorry, I was going the right way. I did the other three. Yeah, I know about the boxcar.
Tender, and I saw it had a piece of wood in my hand. So when I dropped the tender on the ground with the right mouse button, it threw a piece of wood at it. I wonder if it went in or not.
That should do it up. Crazy thing is, I need one of those box cars for the depot.
I
don't know. Well, I know. Let me just take a quick look here. Well, I'm right at zero right now, so that's not bad. Here I'm back order 27, so that would bring me to 64 tools. I already got 63 in there. Well, that's a bonus.
Your car of oil barrels needed too. So.
Well, yeah, but look at that. See, that's what happened. is I took all the boxcars and I loaded the oil field up the last time, and then it was useless.
You're gonna need beams for the oil field, then you're gonna need a bit of stuff for the refinery. So
yeah. Well, no, there's beams down at the yard right now. Bob brought some down. Gotta get some empties up there. I just wanted to get this stuff out of the way.
Do you have any need for more cars at this point or no?
Possibly lumber cars down the road. We don't need any specifically yet. I haven't heard. How's things with our supply of cars, Bob?
I have 20 beams and 10 lumber sitting in the west yard waiting.
No,
waiting
I mean
someone to take them away.
I mean empties. Do you have enough empties as well?
I don't have any empties. The morning everything's full.
Okay. So you don't need any more empties then. We're just basically got the loads ready and okay. 1, 2, 3, 4 ahead, I think.
Should be alright to load that box up.
Yeah, I'll put it ahead just a bit.
Does your program count where the empty cars are too, or just the
no.
loaded ones?
No, just the loaded ones. It can't do it automatically. It only counts what's in the It only counts what's in the Minis Worg car list. So the commodities, whatever
they
have.
But it tracks whether it's empty or full, right?
I mean, I could put a count in there to distinguish. It would take a little bit of coding.
I got an idea.
What, Emmett?
Well, the cars from the RO cars tab, and whatever aren't accounted for as loads can just be attributed as empties.
What do you mean the ones that aren't accounted for?
So, like, it will say all the numbers. Right?
No, I understand that.
What's loaded.
I know
so
that.
The cars that aren't accounted for from the RO cars tab.
Yes.
Could just be added as empty.
Well, I know. That's what Bob was saying. The thing is, then I would have to get a count if. Well, I can do a count if zero.
Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of empties that are starting to hang around.
Yeah, that's true.
Or we need more of them too.
You know, say if someone takes up two strings of beams and one string of lumber to the iron mine and leaves it there.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know when the guy, you know, somebody works on it. You've got your count that there's, you know, those are full loads up there, but then when they get emptied. If they don't show as empties up there, nobody would know to go up and get them, right?
Oh, I see what you mean. Yep. No, I get that. Yeah.
Because for me, I would like to, like if I took up 10 loaded beams to the iron mine, I'd like to bring back 10 empties.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't want to come all that way empty, like just light power. Right?
Well,
switch drains and come back with an
with
empty
the beams, train. You could just come up to the yard anyways, like six or whatever. Just a six car string, because that's all it could fit in that yard anyways. But yeah, I know what you mean. I'll see what I can do.
Yeah, it would be different than counting
No, I know. Yeah, I would have to, I would do something a little bit different with that. I would probably use, I don't know, possibly another column, but I would, just trying to think now. I can count a series, because the number series is all based on the car type, as opposed to the commodity. So we got the 100 series, the 200, 300 series, all that other stuff. So that would be easy enough to put as a car series. Well, it will actually show a commodity, so I can do a count if commodity, because it does actually show a commodity with zero for the last commodity that it held.
Right. Yeah, because you're saying it showed residue in the bottom of the hoppers, or somebody was.
Well, yeah, and it yeah. So that's probably where it's getting it from. But it doesn't change the last commodity, so whatever was in it last, I believe, is what it shows as. But the thing is, it's going to be a commodity that fits that car type. So yeah, I can do a count if whatever, and then I can do a count if what the heck is the one, the count IFS. Count ifs.
Some ifs.
Some ifs is actually what I'm using. Some ifs is what I'm using right now. But the some ifs actually summarizes the total. It actually summarizes the total number of pieces. Count if would actually count the occurrences. I think there's a count ifs too. If there isn't, it won't matter, because then I can at least I can use a count if zero. Count if zero, and then plug in the. So anything that's a zero will count it, and then it'll also specify, it'll summarize the or count the ones for the particular commodity. That's doable. Cool. Yeah, the sum ifs is actually what it's doing right now. I never used sum ifs before. I've used sum if. But I never used some ifs is so that it can do multiple criteria. Because some if can only do one, but some ifs can do multiple criteria, and then the criteria it's looking for, and then the actual value that it's counting, which is, you know, just the one field or one column. So that's worked good. You still awake, buddy?
Yep.
Ooh, that's interesting. Oh, there it is. You gotta go below the hatch. So when you're unloading the, when you're trying to find the count or to toggle the unload, you've actually got to look below the actual door. So you got this very small area, but that's okay. You would never rapidly unload a boxcar. All right, full load. Check this one to be sure. Yep. I got one more pipe back there too. But 65. 9, 18, 36. All right. So if I was to go down to 56. I got no room for that anyways. What do I got room for? Nothing. I got room for a boxcar to the depot. Ouch. I got room for a boxcar to the depot right now.
That's all you got room for, huh?
Well, yeah, I gotta bring the beams in. Because I didn't realize I had the oil field so loaded as well. Wait a minute.
What, you brought more beams down from the freight depot yard?
No, I haven't brought any. Ironworks. Ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. There they are. So, that's where it is. It's the refinery. But I gotta be careful now. Now I gotta plan this. There, I have the lumber. I got the crude oil that's sitting here in loads. See what I'm looking at, Emmett? So I've got at least 58. 58, 59, 60, 64. Jesus. That would get a lot. And we got a lot of lumber. I didn't think the South needed it that bad. Well, that's cool. We're going to be stocking up. Because we're ahead of the demand curve again. We're going to be ahead of the demand curve by the end of tomorrow.
For what? For what commodity?
Oil barrels. Put it this way. Right now, I have loaded up here. I got 65 waiting to be loaded. I've got 36 on this one train. I got one box car that it needs to be at the freight depot. That's it. That's all I really need. If I bring in 36, I'm easily going to produce. If I bring in 36 to the refinery, I'm easily going to produce 90 oil barrels. Yes.
That's a shitlocker full of money.
Yes. But we're ahead of the demand curve now. I mean, it's money, yeah. But we don't have the demand for it. So we're going to be stocking up for a while until we have an oversupply, and then we'll have the demand. Once we have an oversupply and there's nowhere for it to go, we're going to be selling it. Basically, what's going to happen is we're going to be selling it for more, and then demand will go up because it'll be cheap. We'll raise the demand by. It has nothing to do with the. We have nothing to do with the pricing. It has to do with an oversupply of the market. Right now, it's probably quite expensive to get pipes for these retailers because, or not the pipes, the oil barrels, because there's a back order. But we're gonna alleviate that very shortly. Not to mention, I got two full boxcars that are sitting back here of tools that are not needed at the moment. And an extra car. Holy crap. Oh, this is going to be great. I got to switch this now. Fun. I had a funny feeling because the way things were going, I was thinking to myself, we're really producing quite a bit now. That's why I didn't think it was that bad. Oh, is that sweet? Oh, my water temperature's way down there. Yeah, this is crazy. And with that, we'll easily be able to take on excess lumber possibly. But the cool thing about it is the refinery. Because what we might be able to do is stock load a whole bunch of crude oil too, or anything else along the line. Like say for example, iron ore. We can load up a whole shitload of iron ore. Cause it holds a thousand.
Yeah, just be like the sheiks of Iran and just pump the oil out that you want to sell.
Yeah. And the cool thing is with the demand. I think the demand thing we'll have to really think about at some point. For now, we got the logistics down. But that's awesome.
So yeah, if you stop producing, just produce what you need, then, mm-hmm. And let all the pipeline fill up, all the stuff backwards.
Yep, exactly. So I got a loaded boxcar that's going to sit down here. I've got one that I can bring up to the freight depot, which is being called for. And then I got the pipes. The other two boxcars are going to just sit down here as overstock, which will allow more tools to come in down the road if you know, that ever comes to a point, but which is awesome. Okay. Oh, that made my night. What do we got here? 55 fuel. Oh, wow. That didn't take long to fire up. Hey, buddy, are you going upstairs? Emmett?
Yeah.
Are you going upstairs?
Yes,
yeah,
soon.
Yes, soon? What time do you have to go up at?
9 o'clock.
At what?
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock? Okay, so that's like 5 minutes from now.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you do me a favor?
Yep.
Once you're awake, when you don't spill it, can you get me something?
Yep.
Thank you. Did you hear me about all the freaking oil barrels we'll be producing?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Yeah, I gotta be busy.
What's that?
I have stuff to do tomorrow as well as today.
Tomorrow as of today? Well, yeah, but I don't have to worry about producing oil barrels that much.
Yeah.
Like, I'm gonna load two at once, and then I've got the car for that now. Okay.
You guys are gonna get requirements from the, depot again.
Oh, yeah.
Come Wednesday, aren't you? Or is that tomorrow?
Tuesday. We're going to start up Tuesday. For that.
It's Christmas break now.
Yeah, I don't know if they celebrated in the States Boxing Day.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, Boxing Day, no.
No.
No, not back then. Christmas, yeah.
A British rule, maybe?
I don't know.
Definitely. No. No. They have no idea what Boxing Day is in the States.
Awesome.
All
right. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow.
Good night, Emmett.
Good night.
Colin Black. I'm lucky I can watch this on Curbo. I'm a subscriber to both. This is fun. I'm from Newcastle, Australia. Very nice. You basically have to stand outside and look right at the window of the engine to get the F menu, I find. I get used to it. Then they'll change it again.
You throw down the save at when it's convenient. I just filled up the cordwood at the smelter.
Roger that. Give me 30 seconds.
Yeah, whatever you can.
Mm-hmm. Comes. You're saved.
Sweet.
All right. Well, I've got 36 with me. Like I said, that'll put me up to 45. Oh, that was horrible. Oh, I knew I should have left that alone. Lose MacGyver again. He wouldn't have been taking that much, I don't think. Well, you never know. That's what he was doing. He was talking about getting his own internet or something. I don't know how the hell he's going to do that, but... tree. jump up that? Okay. Check that. All right. Finally ready to leave the ironworks. What you working on, Bob?
Filling up cordwood train.
Roger.
I like to keep my trains full.
Uh-huh.
When it's full, I'm going to bring it down to the east yard, put it on one of those tracks. And
sure.
Make sure Yo Daddy is serviced properly.
Thank you. Okay, let's take a look at this yard. Alright, so that's going with me. Question was, where is I going to do that? Three, six, seven, eight, nine, that was 18. Ah. Okay. Put that up to 20. All right, so if I take the beams, let's go down here first. Shove this in. In fact, I gotta get yo daddy to work here. Yo daddy's got some cleaning up to do.
I love switching these switches on the screen with the extender. Holy shit, is this ever fun?
Yeah, I haven't missed the extender that much. Other than teleporting, which we haven't needed since the update, right? No, you haven't needed me for what?
Well, you were riding with me up to the smelter, and then you wanted to go down south. You had to run.
Yeah, but that's okay. That's okay. That's different. That was more leisure. Give people on YouTube a look around, but. All right. See, the border too is much easier to fill because it doesn't pop up that little left thing. The other one takes
doesn't pop up the what thing?
With the F menu. Oh crap. almost had a chemical accident. where we got brakes. Ah, crap. After all that. Was going to happen. Oh, and turn the brake off. Dangerous. Okay, I think I'm all right now. Okay, let's see what we want to do here. So we got the tanks all together now. That opens up another track. Let's go up here. Nice. Okay. Cordwood's cars are coming. Beams are coming. I think. No, the beams are going in there. Beams are going in there, plus one steel pipe. Bring the train in. Or I can hold off. Okay, one steel pipe has to come down first. The rest of the steel pipe would be going the other way, which would give me a total of 36, which I would easily crush. Already got 38 there. 36 would lead to 72, which would put us at 110 oil barrels, which gives us two more cars.
You must stop making oil barrels.
Well, no. I need one. I do need one more. But then 110 is okay, because then it just leaves a full one full car of oil barrels, which can then be brought down to the depot to storage, and then that's it, and they sit down there in that yard we have, so till the last one's ready.
Can you throw a save down? Just completed some stuff.
Yep. Ditto.
And I'll be right back.
Alrighty. Okay, lumber's coming with us. All of it. That's coming with us. Flats are staying here. Okay, let's bring the train in. Yeah, we'll bring the train in. got a water tower over here. Guess I don't. I need one. The firewood depot. Okay, this, first of all, this ain't lumber, this is beams. I just realized that. Yeah, I don't think it's a good, yeah. Oh, I can't do that anymore. It does not work when you try that crap. That is one thing about the Fs. You don't have that emergency shit hit the fan button anymore. Alright. So, all right, I might as well take, man, how much do we want to carry here? We're going to have 4, 7, 8. Okay, hold on a second. Let me see what we really need. Six lumber. We need two trips. Yeah, we need two trips. Trying to think of prioritizing how I want to work this. It's a big switching puzzle. So I bring six lumber over. Number one, I can't do it all at once anyways, so the most I can get is 24. Nope, I can do 30 if I want to process it.
steel pipes, on the other hand, it don't matter. But to get anything going, we know we can unload one here. I can do that right now. Just to get it out of the way. I don't know if I need to. I probably don't. I don't think we need it. So let's focus on this then. Let's forget that. We take 48 crude oil over here. That brings that up to 54. So that's 4 cars worth. And then 6 lumber. But that won't be enough. If I bring 3 tanks, that'll put that up to 42. 3 tanks. Three tanks, 3 pipe. Three tanks, three pipe, 4 lumber. Okay, let's do that. Sounds good. Just gotta decide where I wanna pile everything. Okay, I got an idea. Three tanks, 3 pipe, 4 lumber. That won't quite give us the output, but that's okay. That'll get things started. Oops, did I throw the switch? I don't think I did. Well, I guess I did. I wasn't paying attention.
So leave the caboose on that track. That'll be for us to take down while we assemble this train. Boxcar, I gotta get out of the way. That's heading north. Unless I have a place for it, which I think I do. So I will deal with that right now. See everything that's down there first. Okay, so those are coming next shift. So I got 4, 5, 6 and a boxcar. Which makes sense. Let me double check on this again. So this is also heading back north with us. Good. Bare knuckle. We're gonna go ahead and kick this one. We're good. Double check this. Yeah, I think we'll leave it at 0. Oops, I forgot to let go of the pin. Okay, so I want 3 tanks now. So I want 3 tanks and the caboose, or, and then I can assemble that and get out of the way for the other guy. I even too sure if I went down the right track. Yes, I have. Okay. Really? Ah. After all that. I thought I had the pins. Never assume. No. Had a 9-car string with me and with Joe Daddy, and I didn't have the pin in.
Hey, come on, I'm allowed to make those rookie mistakes because I haven't seen pins.
Yeah. Well, you can see them now, so no excuse. They did a great job. A few little quirks, but I'll take them. I'm not complaining about them. I mean, the biggest issue now is the logs. And I hear too, from what I understand, a lot of the issue could be because it's frozen. So once the log, because apparently it's bouncing up higher or something. Now, it wasn't an issue before, but it is now for some reason. But I heard something like that on the Discord, and I thought, that's interesting.
Yeah, the pond's been frozen for, a week and a half now?
Yeah.
But it was only after that update that it started.
Oh, of course. Problems. Of course, yeah. But they're saying that is... Had that not been frozen, this is likely wouldn't have been an issue because the logs would have gone further or something. But they go underneath anyways, I think, don't they? I don't know.
I always thought I just had to hit the wood deck. That's when it counts them. Water mattered.
Probably. Now that you mention it. Well, there's a lot of. There's a lot of armchair quarterbacks trying to. You never know who's legitimately got real information or what. What the hell? Okay. That's fine. It's this one we needed. Okay, now we're together. Add my caboose and fire up the other guy again. Awesome. This is such a switching puzzle down here. It's cool. Surprised I don't even have a water tower here yet. I thought I did, but I don't see one. Actually gonna bring my first 10 car train up that grade to the refinery once I got this assembled.
Well, that's a big train.
Yeah. Well, it's only the first of two. I think I have to look back. Well, I'll let it roll. I just have to jump out, right? Oh, I'm fine. Nice. I can see that being a possibility. The one switcher working from the one end and the other working from the other. So I got the little guy in the way building the train, and I gotta shove this bat all the way down the line, which is technically a drill track, so kinda got away with it. Okay, time to check all the brakes. At least in the back. Okay, little guy, time to get out of the way. still heating up. That was a bit of a bang. Definite advantage of being able to jump out, especially if it's just rolling against the pin. You know how the weight will sometimes push it a bit. So if it's slightly rolling, you just walk out and boom.
Yeah, I was getting used to that today. Just letting the locomotive just cruise into the car and put the pin in as it hit.
Yeah. Way more advantages with that.
Yep. Overall, I like the update.
Oh, I do too.
It took some getting used to, that's all, but I've adjusted.
Oh, yeah. Alright, 5 departing the oil field for the refinery. Got 4 lumber, 3 pipe, and 3 tanks.
Nice little mixed train.
Actually, sorry, 4 lumber, 4 pipe, and 3 tanks. So 11 plus the caboose, it'd be 11 with the caboose, I guess.
It's a big train for such a short distance.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Speaking of which... going the wrong way. It is, yeah. Thing is, I got another run to come up there to finish it off afterwards, so I figured I'd make it in two runs. This is the input.
We do that at the Holmes Club. We put together a 10 or 11 car train at a Kinnear yard, mm-hmm. and then we head out of the yard pulling the cars, and we have four or five industries that we exchange cars with.
Yeah.
And then we go back to the yard, we push the cars back to the yard, and then we grab another 10 cars, but this time we push those out of the yard because the switch points are going the other way.
Yeah.
And we spend all this time blocking the two sets of cars because we're on the main line and we gotta be efficient with our time because there's all these other trains coming and going.
Mm-hmm. For sure. I said there was some kind of caboose issue with the diamond, but never had that issue.
I don't think we ever saw it.
No. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Break. Break. Ugh. Now, the one disadvantage about not having the F to get, you don't have that little emergency stop out of nowhere. Where I used to... I used to hit the F button, and that would be like the F'd up button. Yeah. Oh boy.
Oh man. Stopped, decided to do fire, and then I forgot to throw the switch. Okay.
Funny thing, in Run 8, I didn't really like switching that much. Like, the industries felt dead to me. I certainly didn't mind it. I had the car forwarding software that I developed and all that other crap, but the industries just didn't feel... I mean, even though you had the unloading and loading, it didn't feel like it was doing anything. This feels like so much more satisfying. Let's see, three there. Couldn't quite get the fourth, and I can only get two at a time of these. Some more.
Longburn 1 or Run 8, which I never played. I guess they were dead because you didn't have any of that car forwarding stuff. But in version 2, they had it.
Well, version 2 has... It had the... It did, it did a little bit of it. I mean, don't get me wrong, it had the waybills and all that other stuff. It had, it did have the loading and stuff like that, but what it didn't have was be able to generate trains. Like, generate trains based on waybills. That's something that 2 can never do like 1 did when I had RTS going. But still, the industries, they just didn't feel... Even in 2,
did
they...
Did you actually see and touch waybills, or you just mean, like, car forwarding?
Oh, just...
You could set up, like, 2 industries that would just trade cars back and forth all day.
Oh, yeah, you can do... You could trade back and forth. It's not that. What I'm saying is, what you couldn't do is generate a train that would come in off the map. Like, you could spawn trains, like pre-made trains, but you couldn't spawn a randomly generated train based on waybills. That's something RTS did in version 1. I could never get it going with version 2. They changed some of the files, the access. Like, I mean, I had access to certain things like I used to, but there was other things as far as like track databases and stuff like that that I didn't have the access that I once did. So but what I'm talking about is the actual physical switching itself, I was never a fan of. I always liked getting them all, you know, all together and basically running the trains. And I like the fact that you would get to, say, a Barstow yard, and you had all these industries that were, like, the logistics behind it I liked. But I didn't like the switching part. Here, I like the switching part and the logistics. The logistics is something that, obviously, that we've, you know, we've done a little bit of our own stuff, but you just follow along, but to give us a bit of demand so that we're not just constantly pumping out certain cars, and give us more of a focus, I guess. But I just love how the industries react, because, you know, watching the piles, you know, fill up and all that other stuff, it's really cool. And to see the actual stockpiles, you know, when you come in, and
yeah, that part's nice in this game.
Oh yeah, for sure. Oh, the return key does work. How about that? I didn't think it did. I figured I'd try it, and that time it worked.
Oh, so it works with both, you're saying?
Yes. I don't know why it didn't work before, or just... Well, it was kind of weird, because I was... I've heard complaints that some people can't get it to work, even though it says the, you know, the right end, the key and everything. And I noticed the, what is it? I noticed I was, I think it was it lumber? Oh, no, it was the last round of pipes. And I would look at it, and I would have the prompt, and I would hit it, and nothing would happen. But you still have to look at the bottom of the car before it will unload. Like, you'll get the prompt, and you'll look up, and you might still have the prompt for a bit. Like, I tried tapping it, I tried 3 seconds, it wasn't going. It was just weird.
Second Life and open up some presents, so I'll catch you tomorrow, Sean.
Okay. Have a good one, man. Take care.
Have a good night.
You too. Got stuck in the logs. Oh, did I get out? I got out. Woo. That's what you get for getting stuck in the logs. I guess it doesn't happen with all of them, but I thought they fixed that. Yeah, well. Once I unload this train, I may call it as well. Been a long 2 days. If the weather's cooperating, I might want to go for a walk before I go to bed. But we'll see. Okay. Might try going down the hill, but we'll see. I think I quite got it on it. Oh, hell no. Yeah, I think that'll do. Gotta be looking at that. Okay. Get our train together and might not be that bad to get it together. I do want to check the output and see where we're at. Supposed to do laundry, but I'm not too sure how I'm going to be doing that. I might be able to swing it by anyways. Kind of weird, that was working earlier and now I'm not getting it. It's like a little magic area. Yeah, you know, it's 10:53. I think I'm going to call it myself once I get this train back together. me go take a look over here while I'm at it. Let's see where we're at here. Lumber's already been gobbled all up. We still got 21 steel pipes. And 18 crude oil. So, we still could use 3 more lumber. That's interesting. Let me go take a look here. Oh boy. What the hell happened here? Okay, is this doing this evenly? I don't know how the hell it's doing it. It was even, but then we kind of broke the evenness, so maybe that's why. Maybe it just keeps adding 2 per 1 and we kind of broke it. 62, 52, 42, 38. I don't know, that's a full one, which is fine by me. Regardless, I'll be able to get that that first one done, and then I'll have to see about the rest. I certainly have the means of generating a lot more. Okay, I must have a break on one of these. Let me go take a look. Well, that's interesting. Just did not like it for some reason.
Hitting the wrong button. There we go. That time it went. Not sure what happened. Shoved it too far. Oh, jeez, yeah. Thought I was going in too heavy. Whew. Well, that's one way of doing it, is just going inside the cab. I'll have to consider that. If it's just as easy to go into the cab to do it, then that's kind of a bonus. There we go. There's a stress test right there with the slack. All right. We're all set for our trip down, but for now we're just going to save it. I'll be back tomorrow morning. Last day off until I go back to work for 2 days and a half. So, and then we'll see you tomorrow morning. Have a good one, guys. We'll talk to you later.